Welcome to my kitchen. Today we're going to learn how to make your own homemade soap. So you can see I have the ingredients over here, and then I have the supplies you'll need over here. And then notice I'm wearing a long sleeve shirt, even though it's July and I'm really hot, because we'll be working with lye and you don't want to get any kind of lye on your arms, it will burn. So let's start over here. Here we have the olive oil, we have grapeseed oil. You can use grapeseed and or canola oil. We have, you can use goat's milk and or cow's milk. We have our own cow, so I use fresh cow's milk. Then you have distilled water back here. Lye, which is a very important part of making your soap. Coconut oil, and then down here I have a Young Living Purification. You can use whatever type of essential oil you want if you want to add that to your soap. This is just the one I'm using today. So then over here you have your supplies. We'll start with, you need a large, medium, and small bowl. Something very important, do not use aluminum when working with lye. It will react to it, so stick with glass or plastic, please. Then you have a glass pan here. This is what we'll dump our soap into. And that's where it will harden. We have a wooden spoon, again, not aluminum. Then we have a large kitchen knife, digital scale. I also like to use this scale. If you don't have digital, you can. You just have to be a little more precise because the measurements are small. But it is possible. I've made many batches with this. So then you have your glass measuring cup, saran wrap, parchment paper, paper towels, you have your gloves you'll be wearing practically the whole time you're working here, and a blender. Blender is very important. Again, I have made lots of batches of soap just stirring it by hand. It takes a long, long time. So if you're going to be making your own soaps from now on, I would suggest purchasing a little handheld blender here. And you notice the surface area is covered in newspaper so that, again, working with lye in your oils, you just don't get all kinds of garbage all over your countertops. So it just keeps your surface area a lot cleaner. And the next step we will do, again, ingredients and supplies you'll need. And now we'll start measuring our ingredients. I haven't given you the measurements. I'll just put them on the screen. It'll just save time as far as video purpose goes. And then you can pause the video as you're measuring them for your soaps and see how much you need of everything. Okay, we're back. So we're gonna start to measure our ingredients and then put them in our large bowl. First, you see I have the scale. I put the empty bowl on. I zeroed out the scale. And now I have olive oil already measured in there. You need 36 ounces of olive oil. So you see I have it measured out. And I forgot to mention we do need a spatula. So we're gonna dump our olive oil now into our large bowl. You're gonna continue to do this with the grapeseed oil, and it's 12 ounces of grapeseed oil. Again, you'll put the bowl back on, then you're gonna zero out and then measure your 12 ounces. And then you're gonna put 8 ounces of your milk, which is already measured down here. After your olive oil, your grapeseed oil, and your milk are in the large bowl, we're gonna come back and we're gonna blend with the blender. You just wanna mix the milk with the oils. Okay, so you can see the milk is emptied, so I've added the olive oil, the grapeseed oil, and the milk. I measured them in a medium bowl, put them in a large bowl, and now, I don't know if you'll be able to tell, but the milk sinks to the bottom because it's heavier, obviously. So now we're just gonna take our immersion blender and just blend it till the oils and the milk look blended. I don't know if you can see this. But you probably only need to blend for a minute to two, no longer than that. Okay, I'm not gonna waste your time watching me blend oils together, but after this, you can see I have zeroed out the scale again, and then next we'll just start adding more ingredients like our coconut oil. And also, you can wear your gloves at any time. And I did put the digital scale here again. Either one, whichever one you're more comfortable using. Okay, so now in the bowl, I have 16 ounces of coconut oil. I measured it. We blended this for a minute, two at the most, just until you can see that it's been mixed. Measure out your coconut oil. We're going to add the coconut oil to the big bowl here. Don't worry if your coconut oil is solid, the lye will melt that very quickly, actually. Okay. So, all right. And then we have distilled water here, already measured 10 ounces. And I am going to remove this bowl. You want your small bowl, set it on the scale. You're going to zero it out. Just zero your bowl out. You want to put on your gloves and your protective eyewear, and then we are going to measure out the lye. Okay, as you can see, I have my gloves on, I use my protective eyewear, and I zeroed out my scale and I measured 8.9 ounces of lye. Lye is not something you want to mess around with. That's why I'm wearing the long sleeve shirt, even though it's July and it's really hot out. Because lye will burn the skin. So you just wanna be really careful. You don't have to be afraid of it, but just use caution while using it. So here's our lye. The next step is I'm going to go outside. If you have a high ventilated area, that's best. I usually just take it outside. You're gonna mix the lye into the water. You're gonna stir with your wooden spoon really slowly, and you're gonna stir until the water runs clear. First, it's gonna look foggy when you're adding the lye into it. And then as you keep stirring slowly and gently, again, lye burns, so you don't wanna just splash it around. Slowly until the water runs clear. And then we're gonna bring it back in, and then we will add it to our large bowl of oils already. Hi, okay, so I'm back inside. I'm gonna keep my protective eye glasses on because I do not want any chance of lye splashing into my eyes. I usually keep these on as I'm blending until it gets a little thicker and I'm not worried about stuff splashing up into my face. So here, it's still a little cloudy, but the lye is dissolved. And so I'm gonna go ahead and again, slowly dump it in here. And there is gonna be somewhat of a fume. So that's why you wanna go in a high ventilated area. So I'm gonna slowly dump this in, trying not to splash. Okay, and then we're gonna blend. And again, it's gonna melt your coconut oil. If you fill the bowl after you put the lye in, it's gonna heat up. Don't be afraid, that's just normal. This entire bowl will be hot to the touch once the lye is starting to blend in. So here again, I'm gonna blend and blend and blend, and at the point where it's pudding, I will come back and show you what it looks like, and then after that, we will add our essential oils. Okay, as you can see, I took my protective eyewear off. I'm gonna tip this up here. It's a little warm, but see, it has a consistency of pudding. So now you need to add 0.5 ounces, which is the size of this bottle of essential oils at this point if you want to. That's what I'm gonna do. After that, we're gonna blend a little more. Okay, and I should have mentioned before, because your soap at this point will start hardening very quickly. So after your essential oils are in and you've blended this, you can see I already have my parchment paper in my pan ready. You can even get that ready before you go out to dump your lye and your water together, and or you can do it before you start blending once you come back in and before you mix. So it looks like my bottle is now empty. I'm gonna set that here. I'm gonna blend a little more and then we're gonna dump it in. Okay, and if I hold this up, see how it's already getting super thick? think I'm just gonna stop it at this point. And we're just gonna dump it into our pan. Okay, just clean off as much as you can. Depending on the type of essential oils you use, it will change color as it cools too. It might become like a darker color, but it will usually dry light. Okay, I'm just gonna call that good. Okay, move our oils over here and then dump it in. Again, your pan is going to be warm, okay? Once you get it in here, you can smooth it out into the corners. You can use two smaller pans or another large one if you need. Usually for one batch, it fits in this one just fine, but if you want soap that's not so thick, you could use two pans and then you'll have a thinner block of soap or bar. Okay, I wanna make sure I get all of this. Just don't wanna waste. Okay, I'm gonna set that to the side. All right, and then again, just push your corners down. Like I said, this is hardening pretty quickly. Once I have it in here, then we're gonna take our Saran wrap and you're just gonna put a layer, you're not gonna push it on it, you're just gonna put a layer gently on the top of the soap. And you're gonna leave it like that until the soap is firm enough to cut with your large kitchen knife. Okay. And okay, you can go as smooth or you can make rough if you want. It roughly looks like that. So I'm gonna get this Saran wrap and we're gonna put a layer on the top. And then we're gonna leave it sit until it's firm enough to cook. Okay, so we're back. We have our soap in a pan. I'm gonna tip this up. It looks kind of dark. That's the heat of the lye coming through, and then as it cools more, it will lighten. So you need to make sure that it's hard enough to cut. You know, it could take 8 to 10 hours, or different climates could take up to 24 hours. Sometimes it could take less than that, so you just keep checking it. But we have our Saran wrap, so once you go to cut it, you pull back the Saran wrap, obviously, and you're gonna take your large kitchen knife. You're gonna cut lengthwise into as big or small of squares as you want for whatever container you have. And or if you have a soap cutter, you could use it at that point too. So over here, I just wanted to show you what it looks like. Once you have the soap cut, you're gonna turn it on its small ends and set it in the pan, removing the parchment paper around it so that it can air dry around it looking like this. So once it's in here, you just put it in a cool, dry place until the soap hardens or cures. That could take up from 3 to 6 weeks. Usually mine's ready in 3 weeks. So if you're running low on soap, you might want to start making yours right away so that it has 3 weeks to cure. So then the blocks, you can make them as big or small. Again, this is thick. So if you don't want it that thick, just put your soap in two separate pans before it cools and before you cut it. So there you go. Now you know how to make your own homemade soap. I hope you enjoy the tutorial. Check out heatherearls.com for more tricks on food tutorials, soaps, and or just healthy living.
Now on a park bench down on 4th Street, that's where I pop the question. And to my amazement, she actually said yes. Tears fill me.